Please.
A very warm good afternoon to my respected DNO sir and all my dear videos, Shantanu also, my colleagues. I will present before you my annual action plan and labor budget for 2021. This presentation is in two parts. In the first part, I will try to take you through the annual action plan for this current financial year, 2019-20. I will show you the block performance in a overview, in a small snapshot, and then we will go to some of the signature schemes that we have managed to do in this year. And then in the second part of the presentation, we will go to the proposed annual action plan and proposed details of financial year 2020-21. So here, this is the first slide. Here you see the number of schemes that we have taken in this financial year, in this annual action plan, total of 6,718 schemes. The categorized breakup has been shown here. Water conservation, for example, there are 152 schemes in water conservation. Micro and minor irrigation works, there are 167 schemes. This is the breakup. Only one scheme is there for common worksheds for livelihood activities of SAG. It is a small SAG hut that we build. Next slide, please. So this is the brief overview of our block performance in 2019-20. Our labor budget was 3,22,325. And as of date, as on 14th January 2020, we have managed to achieve 2,53,538%. This is 78.66%. Households which have been provided work is 5,620. Households who have covered 100 days of work is a little less right now, but we hope that is 131 right now. We hope that as the year ends, in the coming 2 months of this rest of this financial year, we will try to get this close to our estimated amount in the annual action plan. Women working percentage is 64.93, which is a very healthy thing. Next slide. This slide shows the achievement of 2018-19 versus the achievement of 2019-20. This makes the achievement in this financial year does not look so good when compared to the achievement in the last financial year, 2018-19. Primarily because here I would like to submit that 2018-19 was a great successful year for Hodirampur development block as far as MGNREG is concerned. We managed to clock 180% of our labor budget and close to 7 lakh PDs. Also, the number of households which were provided work, you could see, it is almost touching 10,000. And similarly, the number of women households who were provided work was also significantly higher than this year. I'm not saying that I'm not trying very hard. I'm trying very hard, but it is very difficult to replicate this type of stellar performance year after year. We will try to achieve as much as possible in the coming two financial years so that we can live up to the standards of the past year. Next slide, please. So some of the signature schemes of 2019-20. This is Madhukati. I am proud to share before you all that DNO sir only went to Delhi to take the accept on behalf of the Dakhin Dinajpur District Administration the prestigious Koch Award, which was given to Madhukati scheme of Hodirampur. In Madhukati scheme in 2019-20, we have taken 16 number of schemes and 128 households have been benefited out of this. Before we went for the award at Delhi, I made a thorough study of the Madhukati scheme in Hodirampur, and I found that both the area of cultivation under Madhukati as well as the average income per household generated has increased from 2018-19 to 2019-20. So it is a good thing, and we hope that in the next coming year, in 2020-21, we will be able to take this even further. Next slide, please. This is another signature screen, Dragon Fruit. We are emulating Bongshihari development block in this. Bongshihari development block has done very well in dragon fruit cultivation. So we are also trying to develop dragon fruit cultivation. As of now, we have been able to serve 500 farmers through this dragon fruit cultivation. Next is cement concrete road. This is also I have specifically asked my CA to include this slide because it shows that how what kind of permanent asset we have been able to generate through MGNREGA in Hoodinampur. Here you see that we have been able to complete 14 CC roads in this financial year, and 15 are almost nearly completed. It will spill over to the next financial year. Next slide. Four number of Anganwadi centers have been completed and two are under construction as far as this financial year is concerned, and it is really the picture say it all. Next, this is mushroom cultivation. 699 mushroom schemes have been approved and running. Out of them, 425 families are getting benefit in Shirshi GP and 274 families are getting benefit in Bagijapur GP. It is also a very labor intensive scheme because in mushroom there is almost 90 PDs which are generated. So they get a lot of assistance from the government. And this is the slide of NRM works. Next slide, NRM works. This is the labor intensive works. You can see ponds being excavated, canals being desilting of canals, pond excavation, etc. is going on. Next slide. Now we come to the second part of the presentation. This is called Projection 2021. This is what we hope to achieve in the coming financial year. We have kept the labor budget at the same constant, 322,325%. We will, however, try our best to go a little above 100%, maybe 120%, 130%. That will be our target. Households to be provided work, we have decided 7,523 households to be provided work. And household who will be covered 100 days of work is 2,206. This is the summary of the annual action plan, number of schemes. Here you can see that we have taken 3,694 schemes. Total mandates would be generated, 12,88,000 mandates would be generated if all these schemes are implemented. I don't think it is feasible to generate 12 lakh mandates, but we will try to go as close as, stick to the annual action plan as closely as possible and generate as close number of mandates as possible to the targeted figure. And 34 crore rupees would be the total expenditure if all these schemes are implemented. Next slide, please. So this is the form A1 where we show how many total households we are in the previous slide. Take picture. We have seen that 7,523 households would be provided what? Here, this is the breakup of those 7,523 households. Out of those 7,523 households, 1,260 households are vulnerable households who would be provided what in the coming year under MGNREGA. And other households, which is given in declaration in form A2, is 6,263 households would be given what other households. So this combined gives, next slide, combined gives 7,523 households. Next slide. This is a work category summary. GP-wise summary of the action plan. They have total number of works to be taken up. You can see this is self-explanatory, total material cost. We have been instructed, strict instructions were given to the GPs that the material cost should not be more than 35%. So all the GPs have adhered to that, yeah. Except Bagijapur, who have given 37%. We are in constant touch with them and they have been asked to submit a revised estimate. Total for block is 28.61%. Next. This is plantation summary. Roadside plantation, we intend to plant 143.35 kilometers of plantations in the next year, roadside plantation. And in block plantation, we intend to plant 30.5 hectares. Next slide, please. This is the timber plantation continuum, timber, fruit plants, spice plants, floriculture, vetiver, etc. You can see we have only fruit plants, timber and vetiver. So this is the nursery details. As instructed by respected DLO sir, he told us to give our projections regarding nursery. I am glad to say that Hoodinampur has taken up a lot of nursery schemes. 381 total number of nurseries will be constructed, 120 from Panchayat Samiti and you can see the rest from these GPs. So we have a huge supply of saplings, and I also take this opportunity to extend my offer and request to all the fellow block development officers that if in case they need saplings, they can always think of procuring saplings from us. This is livelihood summary. All is as expected. Next slide. Agri and allied activities. Roughly the technical details. Next. NRM summary. The natural resource management works, total number of schemes for NRM. It is supposed to be not less than 70%, and it is 72% for our block. Rural road also, you can say, rural road needs to be converted durable. It was my intention to show how MGNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Livelihood Mission is helping us to develop durable assets for the rural people, and I thank my DNO sir and all my BDOs from the Horirampur Development Block. This is Sriman Banerjee, BDO Horirampur.